குட் மார்னிங் ஸ்டூடெண்ட்ஸ், வெல்கம் டு 6th ஸ்டாண்டர்ட் சோஷியல் கிளாஸ். ஸ்டூடெண்ட்ஸ், ஃப்ரம் டுடே ஆன்வர்ஸ் வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு ஸ்டார்ட் அ செகண்ட் டேர்ம் போர்ஷன். ஓகே, ஸோ பிஃபோர் வி ஸ்டார்ட் த லெசன், வி ஹவ் டு சீ த வாட் ஆர் த கண்டென்ட்ஸ், ஹவு மெனி லெசன்ஸ் ஃபார் செகண்ட் டேர்ம். ஸோ வி ஹவ் டு சீ த லெசன்ஸ் ஃபஸ்ட், ஆஃப்டர்வர்ட்ஸ் வி டேக் த கிளாஸ் சில்ட்ரன். ஓகே, கண்டென்ட்ஸ் here: history, geography, civics and economics. Okay, history, geography, civics and economics. So first term we have to study only history, geography and civics. There are three divisions only we have to study. Okay, now they have to add at extra economics we have to see. Okay, so in history there are three units. First units: Vedic culture in North India and Megalithic culture in South India. Second unit: great thinkers and new faiths. Third units: from chiefdoms to empire. Okay, these three lessons for history. Next, geography, only one unit, that is resources. Okay, next one, civics. Under civics there are two units. First unit: national symbols. Second unit: the constitution of India. There are two lessons in civics. Okay, and last one is economics. In economics there is only one lesson, that is economics and introduction. Okay children, so totally how many lessons? For history 3 lessons, geography 1, 4, civics 2, 5, 6 and economics 1. So totally 7 lessons for second term. Okay children, let's start the lesson. Now first we have to see history, unit 1, Vedic culture in North India and Megalithic culture in South India. There are two cultures taking place in India. At the same time there are two cultures taking place in India. One is North India, another one is South India. In North India, Vedic culture, they introduced Vedic culture. At the same time in South India they have to enter the Megalithic culture. People enter into Megalithic culture. So at a time in North India and South India, Vedic culture and Megalithic culture is taken place. Okay, now we are going to start the lesson. Before we start the lesson, we have to see what are all the points we are going to discuss in this lesson, that is learning objectives. Okay, first point: to know the origin and migration of Aryans into India. Second point: to identify the sources of study relating to the Vedic age. Third point: to understand the evolution of political, economic and the religious structures in Rig Vedic and later Vedic societies. Fourth point: to locate the regions inhabited by both early and later Vedic people. Fifth point: to make the differences between early and later Vedic periods. Last point: to understand the Megalithic Iron Age culture in Tamil Nadu. These are all the points we are going to discuss in this lesson. First, Vedic Age. The first phase of urbanization in India came to an end with the decline of Indus civilization. Already we studied in first term Indus civilization. Before Indus civilization, people, the early people is a nomadic life. They lead a nomadic life. Nomadic life means they are not settled in proper place. They are moving from place to place. That is called nomadic life. After this period, after the Indus civilization, the new age, that is Vedic age, is started. Vedic age is started. Okay. So, a new era called Vedic age began with the arrival of Aryans. When the Aryans, the people of Aryans came to India, they started a new era that is called Vedic age. Okay. Vedic age, it is the period in the history of India between 1500 BC. That is before Common Era to 600 BC. BCE means before Common Era. It gets its name from four Vedas. Four Vedas. Who were the Aryans? Who were the Aryans? The Aryans were Indo-Aryan language speaking semi-nomadic pastoralist. Who were the Aryans, children? The Aryans were Indo-Aryan language speaking. Aryans means Indo-Aryan language speaking semi-nomadic. Nomadic means they move from place to place. Semi means little bit only they move. Most of the time they stayed in particular place and sometimes they move. Okay, so semi-nomadic pastoralist. Okay. Next one, they came from Central Asia in several waves of migration through Khyber Pass of Hindu Kush Mountains. From where the Aryans people came? So see the picture, children. See this picture. They came from, the Aryans came from Central Asia in several waves. In several waves of migration through where? Through Khyber Pass of Hindu Kush Mountains. Through Hindu Kush Mountains only the Aryans came to India from Central Asia. Okay, it's clear, children. Though cattle rearing was their main occupation, the Aryans people main occupation is cattle rearing. Cattle rearing means what? They keep cows, sheep, like this. Okay, so their main occupation was cattle rearing. They also practiced slash and burn agriculture. They practiced slash and burn agriculture. Let's know the meaning of slash and burn agriculture, children. Slash and burn agriculture. It is a farming method that involves clearing the land by cutting and burning all the trees and plants on it. Cultivation is done there for a short time and then abandoned. People then move to a new piece of land for cultivation. After cultivation is over, they cut off the trees, plants, and they fired. Okay, so afterwards they moved to some other places. Again they started the cultivation. That is called slash and burn agriculture method. Okay, it's clear, children. Next one, extent of Vedic culture. Extent of Vedic culture. See, there are two colors given. That green color. Green color, it denotes the early Vedic period. This green color and all, early Vedic period. It includes Harappa, Taxila. Okay. And yellow color, later Vedic period. Later Vedic period. Okay. Yamuna, Ganga, Ayodhya and so many places it includes. So, green color, early Vedic period. Yellow color, later Vedic period. Okay. Next one. time spread and sources. Time spread and sources. Geographical range, North India. Geographical range, they came to North India only. Okay, North India. Period, Iron Age. People used, introduced to use iron materials. That is called Iron Age. Time, 1500 BC. That is before Common Era to 600 BCE. Sources, from where we get the materials and all, that is Vedic literature. Next one, nature of civilization ruler. Okay, next one, Aryans and their home in India. Aryans and their home in India. Aryans, they came from Central Asia to North India, and which are the places they settled. Okay, Aryans of the Rig Vedic period were semi-nomadic. Already we studied. They were basically pastoral people with cattle as their main source of wealth. They keep sheep, cows and all. So that is called cattle, their main source of wealth. In the Rig Vedic times, the Aryan homeland was the Punjab. The main place, the homeland was the Punjab, which was at that time called Sabda Sindhu. Now it is called as Punjab. Before, the Punjab name is Sabda Sindhu. Sabda Sindhu means the land of seven rivers. The land of seven rivers. So in Punjab there are seven rivers flows. So that is called Sabda Sindhu. Okay. Around 1000 BCE. Around 1000 BCE, Aryans in India moved eastward. Which direction, children? Eastward, and settled in Indo-Gangetic Plain. The Aryans settled, moved to eastward and settled in particular place. Which place? Indo-Gangetic Plain. Indo-Gangetic Plain. Okay. Next one, sources. And next one, use of iron axes and plugs became widespread. They used to iron axes for cultivation. Okay. Next one, four Vedas. What are the four Vedas? First one, Rig. Second one, Yajur. Third one, Sama. Fourth one, Atharva. There are four Vedas. Rig Veda, Yajur Veda, Sama Veda, Atharva Veda. Okay. Next one, sources. What are the sources? What are the evidences? Okay, Vedic literature. Vedic literature can be classified into two broad categories. Two broad categories. One is Shrutis. One is Shrutis. Second one is Smritis. First we have to see Shrutis. The Shrutis comprise the four Vedas, the Brahmanas, the Aranyakas, and the Upanishads. Okay, what are the three, children? The Brahmanas, the Aryanakas, and the Upanishads. They are considered sacred, eternal, and an unquestionable truth. Sacred also pure. Eternal means future, long, ever-ending, and unquestionable truth. Okay. Shruti means listening. Shruti means listening or unwritten. Ones that were transmitted orally through generation. They are not keep the evidence unwritten. They are orally through generations. Okay. Next one, Smritis. A body of text containing teachings on religion such as Idigasas, Pranas, Tantras and Ahamas. Smritis are not eternal. They are constantly revised. Smriti means definite and written literature. Okay, see, we have to see the difference between Shruti and Smriti. First one, center, Vedic text. There are two Shruti and Simritis. In Shruti, Vedas, that is Brahmanas, Aryankas, Upanishads. Okay, these opposite sides, Simriti, Idihasas, Pranas, Idihasas, Ramayana, Mahabharata, Pranas, Shiva Prana, Vishnu Prana, and Sutras, Dharma Sutra, Manush Simriti, and Narada Simriti. Okay, these are the things. Okay, next our national motto, Satyameve Jayate. Truth alone trumps. It takes from Motaka Supanish. Okay, next one, classification of Vedic age. Two phases of Vedic age. One is early Vedic period, that is 1500 to 1000 BCE, and later Vedic period, 1000 to 600 BCE. Okay, next one, archaeological sources. Archaeological sources. Material remains such as iron implements and pottery from the archaeological sites in Punjab, Uttar Pradesh and Rajasthan along the Indus and the Ganges. So what are the archaeologicals? They find out the sources in which places? In Punjab, Uttar Pradesh and Rajasthan along the Indus and the Ganges. Which material they taken? Pottery. The people used to pot, no? So that pot they have to take, and that is the main sources for the Aryans people. Okay, children, thank you.